It's 92.7 WOBM Ocean County Paranormal. It's Justin Lewis. I am here with Garden State Ghost Hunters founder Boni Bates, as always.
Boni, hello.
Thank you for being here.
No problem.
And Brandon Reber, who is a new member of Garden
Yay.
State Ghost Hunters. And we're going to talk to you a little bit later because we did an investigation a couple weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
It's interesting, since the last time we were here, we talked about Gettysburg.
Right.
And, you know, we had that on the website at WOBM.com. It's still there. If you go to Ocean County Paranormal, you can listen to that. And this time, we went back to an old place. A lot of history. What is it about the old places that make for good investigations, you think?
Pretty much the residual energy left behind, the events that have happened or occurred throughout the years that left imprints, things like that. I generally like to go to all kinds of historic places just to see, just curiosity, to actually see in research if there is evidence of paranormal. You know, pick out a location like I did with one of the places in Asbury Park. I went there on a rainy day. I looked at the building, and I knew it had a lot of history. I knew it had a lot of stories to tell, and I wound up getting in there, and we did a lot of investigations.
Can we talk about that? Where is that?
You want to talk about that? That's the Paramount.
The Paramount Theater in Asbury
Paramount
Park?
Paramount Theater, yeah.
And so that's what you were just drawn to it just by walking through?
Yeah, it was weird. And I didn't even walk through it. It was raining. I was in the truck, and I looked at it, and it had such a eerie feel about it. And, I said to my husband, I want to get in there. So I made the contacts. I found out who to talk to, and they liked what I had to say and what I had to offer, and they let us in. And we've gone there several times since. And every time we go, it's always something different.
What kind of stuff do you get there?
Well, basically, you see, you know, if you sit in the seats in front of the stage and just let everything play itself out, you actually see shadow people walking back and forth on the mm-hmm. stage, or actually popping out from what there was a piano one time, just popping up to see who's looking at them, and they pop back down.
So you actually, now, I want the Paramount Theater, for those who don't know, in Asbury Park, it is a very old theater. It goes back to, I know, at least the early 1900s, right on the beach, right on the boardwalk there in Asbury Park. A lot of heavy history mm-hmm. attached to the place, tragedies, things like that. So you've talked about the shadow people
mm-hmm.
before.
Right.
I have sat with you in the audience, in the seating area at the Paramount Theater. I don't see it. How mm-hmm. come? How come you see it and I don't?
Well, they're fast,
mm-hmm.
number one. And, you know, they're darker than the dark. And even though there's, like, these little red exit lights that are on inside there, you know, sometimes what we do is we cover them up with whoever's jacket or whatever it is just to, you know, close it out. But when you allow your eyes to adjust, which may take about 15 minutes, and you don't look for them. You kind of just go into like an alpha stage, you know, like where you're daydreaming and you just kind of, and all of a sudden you just see things darting from left to right or actually going up the wall. And there's a crack. There's these storage doors that are on the stage where they keep their equipment. And there's a light on for whatever reason. And you actually see the light, you know, them blocking the light. They go back and forth and you're like, whoa. And of course, you never catch it on film.
Of course.
We have cameras in every corner, but you never get it.
Are there some people that are more sensitive to it than others? You know, is it possible that for whatever reason, I don't want to say have a gift, but are there?
Well, you don't need a gift to see shadows because it doesn't really, you don't use the gift. The gift is something where if you're talking about being a medium, who are sensitive, it's a different feel of energy. You know, the vibrations, you know, they're faster, we're slower, we're dense, we got a body, they don't. And mediums usually have to kind of allow themselves to meet up to their vibrations, and, you know, they have to slow themselves down in order for us to even get an imprint or an idea of who's there. So you can't use that to see shadow people, but it's just the training of the eye, you know, letting it happen. Don't look for it.
So the shadows, are those the types of things that when people talk about seeing something out of the corner of their
mm-hmm.
eye, you know, if they're at a house or at an old building, and, you know, a lot of the activity that people think is paranormal
right.
are things that they'll see out of the corner of their
out
eye
of the
and you look
their
and there's
eye.
Nothing there.
Right.
Is that what we're talking about?
Yeah, pretty much, because they're really fast. Again, you have to have a trained eye just for it, and hopefully your camera can pick them up. It's just a matter of waiting and seeing, you know. I mean, you can't focus on it. It comes so unexpectedly. There was a time where we did a slot for CBS News in Philly, and it was, I think, CBS 3. And we showed them the footage of where me and the team were inside. I was kind of standing in the background, and they were up in a room, and I saw the shadow person coming, and they're darker than the dark. And I remember saying, look out, he's right, and boom, it hit one of the team members' arms. The FLIR didn't go up in the air, but the flashlight did. It was knocked out of his hand, and we had all that on evidence, you know, on tape. And they showed that on the news, and
is that the one that's at GardenStateGhostHunters.com?
No.
Okay.
No, yeah, it's a different
There is one from that theater, though.
Oh, that, yeah, this was from another private residence we did. Okay. Yeah, that's when the spirit or a shadow person knocked the flashlight out of the guy's hand. Thank God it was the flashlight and not the FLIR.
So the shadow person isn't just a shadow. It is an actual, like,
it's an actual entity of some sort. You know, a theory on it is that an apparition doesn't have come to full manifestation.
Okay.
And it gets maybe to the shadow point.
So that's the
Just one theory. Other is demons and, you know.
So a fully manifested apparition would be the stereotypical lady in white, you know, or something like that. So a shadow is, that's before they have the energy to
Right, they don't have enough energy to actually show themselves, so they are the shadow. That's if that's true. I have yet to figure it out. But when I see him, I'm so used to it. You know, like, they just sit and go by, and you're like, did you see that? You know, you have to make sure someone else saw it, otherwise you think it's something from the corner of your eye, as usual.
Right, and it's funny because, you know, in the number of times that we have been places like the Paramount, other places like that, and it's not just you, it's other members of the team. Mm-hmm. Did you see that?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, did you see that? I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is that I just...
I don't
catch it.
Yeah, don't try too hard.
I'm trying to.
I've had members quit because they actually were sitting in those seats. And one of the members, all she did was turn, and there was a body sitting right there next to her. She got up, and she was hysterical crying. She knows what she saw, and that was it. She ain't back again.
Is that one of the times I was there? Because I do remember one of the times that we were there, that we were sitting out in the seating area, in the audience area, mm-hmm. and a female member thought she saw something and got pretty
hysterical,
upset by it.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I do remember that.
Yeah,
but,
and then you hear voices, and then, you know, there's a lot of different things being broken. Like one time there was one of the team members was down the end of the hall, and they were talking, and I was at the other end, and all of a sudden you hear, you know, crash, boom, and something breaking, and it was a light bulb thrown at him.
Okay.
So, I mean, there's things that are going on, and I think he was asking, do you want us to leave or something, and you hear the crash.
So, again, so it's these old places that mm-hmm. you kind of get the feeling.
Yeah. That, and, you know, you do this long enough, you actually start to know when they're around, too. You get a feel for this. You don't have to be a sensitive or a medium.
Mm-hmm.
You learn the abilities and the energies. You actually sort them out.
Okay. And we're going to talk about Burlington Prison. Before we get to that, we've got some audio to play. We've got some pictures to look at. What first brought you to Burlington Prison? This is in
Mount Holly, Laurel.
That's right. Yeah.
That's a good question. You know, I it's a historical place. Sometimes people say you ought to check this out. It's really, you know, interesting. It has some activity. So what I'll do is I'll, you know, again, make the phone call and talk to the right people. Tell them who we are, our credibility. And they'll say, sure. You know, we'd love to have you here. And then we set up our cameras and. It's always something different.
You've been there a couple times.
Yes. Okay. Burlington has its own history. It's a prison. You know, it's held notorious people in there for, you know, the crimes they committed and murders and stuff. So, you know, there's issues going on here you want to maybe check out.
Okay. All right. Well, we will talk about that when we come back. Like I said, we've got some audio to listen to. We've got some pictures to take a look at from the investigation at Burlington County Prison. It is Ocean County Paranormal here on 92.7 WOBM, and we'll be right back with more about the Burlington County Prison investigation.